Hey, welcome back to episode 23. I've got a really good one for you today, but before we get to that, I'm pretty sure you noticed some of the man treasure coming up from the snow because the snow is kind of disappearing around here. So I got to address that in the next couple weeks. But in this video here today, let's talk about this. I'm making these and casting them in the backyard. Now this project's a really good one because we're going a little bit thinner and we got them a lot straighter. Kelly Caulfield, he's pretty instrumental in helping me to get these straight. But we'll touch on that in a bit. This project I'm doing for a friend of mine who has a construction company, in case you hadn't guessed, and he's doing very well right now. In fact, he's doing a couple big projects that I suspect that he wants to put these on. After the CNC was finished with them, it was just a matter of taking them out and putting a light coating on. And a special thanks to Steve Zurate in his last video just recently. Check the link below. He tested the differences between the three coatings and found that the lighter coating is almost as good as a heavier coating. Now, today's advancement in learning came from Kelly, of course, the guru, so to speak, and he suggested that it was a matter of filling it in stages to keeping everything straight. So firstly, I'll put the base in, compact it, then put another light coating of sand on the bottom, and then I'll place in the parts. And then I'm going to compact it in steps as I go up. This does, in fact, create quite a bit less distortion in the parts. These parts were 3 inches by 8 inches long and 1/4 inch thick, of foam of course, which is pretty flexible. In episode 24, I'm going to use a bit of a different technique for much larger parts. This involved sodium silicate as a binder for sand, and it worked out quite well, so you have to stay tuned for that one. But back to here and now. The top right part does have a bit of distortion, but it was pretty marginal. I think it was a 16th, if that, and it was pretty easy to bend back once I got it on the workbench and finished. And I might add that side also did freeze up when I poured it, but being the smart, astute fella, I always try to cast extra, and in the end, I got 3. The aluminum I'm using today is a bunch of recycled industrial parts, and it's been working out pretty well, but I'm starting to run low on them, so I'm gonna have to start scrounging around for some more. Remember, full disclaimer, if you're going to try aluminum casting in your backyard yourself, make sure you do a ton of research and don't just go off of what I do. Watch what a bunch of other professionals do and read a bunch of books. This is probably the best way to protect you. On that note, in the link below, I'll put a list to a book that you should probably read if you're interested in casting. Although it's not Lost Foam Casting, it's a pretty darn good book. This is my second favorite part of the whole process, seeing if things work. And it didn't quite all work, but 3/4 of it worked, and I'm pretty happy with that. Whoa, don't go clicking off yet, because this isn't done. We're going to do the 2-part epoxy process yet, which I might add is going to make it look pretty deadly, and it's pretty simple. Now, I'm not going to get bogged down with being exact, perfect, with 50-50, but I'm going to get it pretty close by eye. But you got to make sure that your acrylic paint isn't more than 10% of your total volume, or you're going to have major problems. I'm pretty sure I'm nowhere near that. I highly recommend you splurging on a 39-cent syringe to put the epoxy on. Well worth the money. I did wind up having to put some gloves on after, and that was more to squeegee off the top surface so that it had that real good shine look and sharp detail. We turned out a fantastic product, and I'm pretty happy with it. But let's pick it apart so we all can learn something. And that means you too in the comments down below, please. Where I just pointed at my thumb there is a laminar layer where the 2 oxide layers folded together. In this project, it's fine, but in an industrial part, it could end up being a crack later on and having a big issue. Hey, if you made it this far into the video, it might be a good time to hit the subscribe button because I got some pretty cool ones coming down the pipe and I know you're gonna like them. What are you doing, man? What are you doing? How's it going? How's it going? Huh? Yeah, how's it going? You're gonna get me all dirty. I know. All right. All right.